Hi everybody, I'm Chef Scott. This is Devil's Food Kitchen, and today we are talking about five essential tools for baking and pastry. Now, the term essential is a little subjective. What's essential to one person may not be for someone else, but I tried to put together a list of universal tools that cover a wide variety of recipes. Of course, links to all of the tools that I talk about will be in the description below. Let's get into it. I want to take a quick moment to give some honorable mentions, and that is for a bench cutter or bench scraper and a sifter, also known as a tamis. Having a good version of each of these tools is really, really important. They're not essential, but it makes the job a lot easier. A bench scraper is great for portioning out dough, for portioning out ingredients like butter, and then of course it is really great for finishing off any cakes. So if you're a cake decorator out there, having one of these is crucial. If you do get a bench scraper or a bench cutter, I recommend getting one that is one piece and simply rolled, because I have no lip on the top or bottom of this that can get in the way of a turntable if I'm trying to finish off the side of the cake. That comes in handy. Secondly, the sifter. Having a tamis or this professional style sifter makes the job so much easier. You can simply put down a piece of parchment paper, sift out your ingredients over that, and then they're ready to go into whatever recipe you're making. These are pretty cheap and I think absolutely worth the money. So these get honorable mention, but they didn't quite make it to the essentials list. Let's talk about the first essential tool. That's right, folks, it should come as no surprise if you have watched any of my videos that the first essential tool is a gram scale. I have a whole separate video on this. I'm not gonna go into why this is so important, but if you're measuring anything for any recipe, a gram scale is the way to go. It's just the most accurate and consistent way to measure. Enough said, check out the video if you're still not convinced. Essential tool number two is a little bit of a cheat here because I'm actually talking about two items, but first and foremost, you need a flat surface to bake on. This is a standard half sheet pan. And every restaurant in the country, if not the world, uses basically this sheet pan. These are aluminum, they're lightweight, they have this rolled lip which will distribute heat evenly, and they're also great for casting something in here. I could pour mousse into this to get a flat layer, I can do a sheet of cake. It's not just about having a sheet for cookie baking. These are incredibly useful. They're also really cheap. And then on top of that, I have a silicone baking mat. This is woven fiberglass that has then been covered in silicone. It makes them flexible, heat-proof, and nothing sticks to them. Sure, you can bake cookies or cakes on here and it's not gonna stick, but you can do so much else, whether it's mixing or rolling fondant, doughs, casting mousse or creams onto them. You can use them for chocolate work or sugar work. The list goes on and on and on. You just need to clean them with warm soapy water and keep them either flat or rolled up. You just don't want to crease them because that ruins the weave. But having a good sheet pan and a non-stick baking mat is going to make baking life so much easier. Essential tool number three is my favorite tool in my knife kit, and that is an offset spatula. Offset refers to the shape of the blade in relation to the handle. This is what I use to spread everything from cake batter to mousse to custards to frosting. It's how I finish a cake. These have a million uses. The offset handle makes it really easy to get into a sheet pan to maneuver something, and it also lets you lift product up off of a table or work surface without your hand hitting that table. This is a truly essential tool to have in your kit. Essential tool number four is a digital probe thermometer. These have a really easy to read display screen and easy to use interface. They can take temperature in Fahrenheit or Celsius. It has a timer on it and it has a temperature alarm so that it lets you know when you reach a certain point. These are great for confectionery work if you're cooking sugar syrups. They're great for making custards or mousse bases. And you can even use it as an internal probe for baked goods in the oven, things like bread or cake, or even for savory cooking. I use this for all of my protein because it has this great heat-proof cord that then leads to the probe thermometer. So I can stick this into whatever I'm cooking, leave this outside the oven, and set the timer to let me know when it's exactly where I want it to be. These are incredibly useful. Essential tool number five is a good set of piping tips. There's a million different sizes and styles of tips out there. I'm really just talking about a good set of round tips and a good set of star tips. There are a lot of opportunities for piping product, whether it's in its raw state or for decorating, and piping tips are really the only good way to do that. I'm not talking about these decorative sets. Now, you'll see these sold in hobby stores or for cake decorators specifically. They're smaller in size and they have this detachable coupler, which makes switching out tips really easy to do. Now, if you're doing a lot of decoration, either cake decorating or cookie decorating, then I think getting a set of these is a good idea. But in terms of basic baking and pastry, I really think that a round and star set is all you actually need. Those are my five essential tools for any baking or pastry project. If you get those five items, they're going to give you a really great foundation for tackling most recipes. And from there, you can custom order the little tools that you need project by project. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please consider liking, commenting, sharing, and subscribing. And if you have subscribed, please don't forget to turn on notifications so that you never miss another DFK video when it pops up. Until next time, I'm Chef Scott for Devil's Food Kitchen.